Big sale, big savings at oldtimeradiodvd.com. All of our collections. The prices have been slashed. Pricing will be good until January the 1st, 2018, so don't wait. Buy today and enjoy for a lifetime at oldtimeradiodvd.com. You'll be glad you did.
Around Dodge City and in the territory on West, there's just one way to handle the killers and the spoilers, and that's with a U.S. Marshal and the smell of gun smoke. Starring William Conrad, the story of the violence that moved west with young America, and the story of a man who moved with it.
I'm that man, Matt Dillon, United States Marshal. The first man they look for and the last they want to meet. It's a chancy job, and it makes a man watchful and a little lonely.
Biscuits be done directly.
Is the coffee made? That's what I need.
It's boiling. I didn't make much, though. Thought I'd better save the water, seems how we made dry camp.
Well, first up you woke up so early this morning.
Oh, I always do that. Soon as it gets daylight, my feet start to sweat, seems like, and I just naturally gotta get up.
That's as good a reason as any, I guess. Looks like we got company.
What? Where?
No, right over there, heading straight for us.
Oh. Some cowboy, probably.
I don't know. He doesn't ride like a cowboy.
Well, that's just a kid, Mr. John.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
Sure does need a haircut. Well, I declare he's a girl.
Now, what could she be doing on here?
Carrying a rifle, too.
Ah, morning, miss. Want to get out and have some coffee with us?
Who are you, mister?
I'm a U.S. Marshal out of Dodge, ma'am.
A U.S. Marshal? Oh, that's good.
It is? Why?
But I need help, Marshal. My daddy's awful sick.
Oh, well, what's he sick with?
It's his leg, Marshal. A horse threw him and his cattle both in the corral, and then it stepped on his foot. And now his whole leg's all funny. He's got a fever, too.
Marshal. That sounds like...
Yeah, I know, Chester. Tell me, miss, when a horse stepped on him, did it cut his foot? Did it break the skin anywhere?
Well, it's just a scratch. It tore his boot off, though. Oh, please come and see him. I'm scared the way his leg is and everything.
Oh, sure, we'll come. Is your mother with him now?
I don't have a mother, Marshal.
Oh, well, then what are you doing out here if your daddy's sick?
We ran out of meat about 3 days ago, and I don't have anything to feed him.
Oh. Chester, I'll ride back with her. What is your name, anyway?
Tara. Tara Hawtree.
Oh.
I'll be 16 next January.
Well, that's fine, Tara. Chester, we'll go back to the Hawtree place, and you scout around for some meat, huh?
I see.
And if you don't find any antelope, shoot the first calf you see. Anybody's calf.
I'll do it, Mr. Dillon.
Heard of you. You're from Dodge, ain't you?
Yeah, that's right, sir.
Well, Marshal, ain't feeling so good. My foot don't hurt me no more, but it and my leg is all sort of, it ain't pretty.
I don't know much about these things, Mr. Hawtree, but maybe I better take a look at it anyway.
Sure, Marshal. There she is.
Yeah, all right. scratch it and cover it up.
I was in the war, Marshal. I know what gangrene is. Guess you do, too.
Yeah. Well, the first thing, Mr. Hawtree, a friend of mine's out getting you some meat, and then we'll load you into your wagon.
Oh, Ben took the wagon.
What?
Ben Marlin. He took the wagon when Daddy got hurt. He said he'd find a doctor and bring him back.
Well, who's Ben Walling?
He's been sort of working here, Marshal.
I should have run him off long ago. That's where.
So where is he? Where'd he pick the wagon? Was he going to find a doctor around here anyway?
The closest doctor's in Dodge I knew of. But I couldn't get to him anyway.
Tell me, Mr. Hawtree, when did this happen?
About 6 days ago, Marshal. Ben left the day after.
Well, you think he's coming back?
He come back here. And me not able to get around. I don't know what I'll do. I'll take a bullwhip to him. A bullwhip.
Now, take it easy, Mr. Hawtree. Take it easy now. He won't cause any trouble, so don't you get all worked up about it. Tara, let's let him get some rest, huh?
All right, sir.
Now, we'll have some food for you real soon, Mr. Hawtree.
I ain't very hungry.
Tara, what's he so riled up about this Ben Walling for? What's between them?
Oh, it's nothing, Marshal. Daddy shook me. That's all.
Look, Tara, you trust me, don't you?
Daddy hates Ben because Ben... Well, Ben likes me.
Oh, I see.
He even wanted to marry me. He said he would.
How do you feel about Ben? Do you like him?
Well, it's time I had a man and all that, but I'm afraid of Ben, Marshal. It's like there's something wrong with him. He's always sneaking around when you don't expect him. It makes me uneasy, like. Marshal?
Yeah?
I'm awful glad you're here.
Cutting his leg off?
I don't know, Chester. I don't know. Maybe it's too late anyway.
Well, I sure do wish we could do something for him. I don't take to sitting around just waiting for a man to die.
Nobody does.
It ain't right somehow. That poor fellow and Tara, but Mr. Dillon, that girl go crazy out here.
All right, Chester. What do you want me to do about it? I'm not a doctor. I just shut up.
Mr. Dillon, you could do it. Mr. Dillon? I know you could.
Do what?
Be a doctor. Long enough to save Mr. Hawkins' life, anyway.
Oh, are you out of your head?
No, sir.
Well, what are you talking like that for? The most I ever did was doctor a horse for the colic. That's fine training for this business.
I know. But I couldn't do it. I just plain don't have the spirit, but you do. Mr. Dillon, you wouldn't ever just stand by and let a man die.
Let's go talk to him, Chester.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Spaghetti fever's worse, Marshal. I'm going to get some more water.
Mr. Hawtree, how do you feel?
Yeah, I don't feel much, Marshal. Outside of burning up. I've been trying to tell Tara I can't last long with blood poisoning. And she's just got to figure on it.
That's what I came in to talk to you about, huh? I guess you know the only thing that'll give you a chance.
I know. But I couldn't ask any man to do that.
Now, you didn't ask me. It's up to you, Mr. Hawtree. I'll try it if you're willing.
If it was just me, I wouldn't do it, but I can't leave Tara alone. Not if I can help it, I can't.
You're a brave man.
Oh, Marshal. I just don't have any choice. Come on. Let's get it over with.
Have you got any liquor in the house?
There's a jug of corn out in the kitchen.
Chester, go get it, please.
And tell Tara to start boiling a lot of water. I'll talk to her in a few minutes.
I'll be right there.
Now, Mr. Hawtree, you tell me everything you know about this, huh?
Yeah. First, I'll tell you what you need. There's a straight iron out by the corral somewhere.
Yeah.
You can heat it in the main room fireplace.
All right, fine. Now, what else?
Yeah. Tara will find some cloth for bandages. And the rest of the stuff you can get in the kitchen. The only thing worrying me is what we'll use to tie off the arteries with. Plain thread won't hold.
Well, maybe some thin strips of rawhide.
No. That'll soak through. Something.
Wait a minute. I think it'll work. What about horsehair?
Huh? Yeah, that's it, Marshal. Pull it off the tail. It'll work fine.
Use the jug, Mr. Hawtree, and I brought you a cup, too.
Pour me some. I want to get good and drunk.
Here you are.
Thanks.
Mr. Hawtree, you better have your talk with Tara before that stuff takes hold, huh?
Ask her to come in, will you?
Yeah.
Oh, Marshal.
Yeah?
I'll try to make it easy for you.
Shortly after noon, I operated. Whether it was the corn whiskey or his own hard courage, I don't know, but Hawtree never whimpered. Chester stood outside the door and brought me whatever I needed, and Tara waited in the kitchen, boiling more water, thinking her thoughts. And toward the end, Hawtree mercifully passed out. I finished and left the house for a breath of air. I'd done everything I could, and I just hoped that I'd done it right.
I swear it beats me, Mr. Dunhouse. He just lays in there so quiet and peaceful.
It's only been 4 or 5 hours, Chester. The liquor hasn't worn off yet.
Well, he drunk up nearly the whole jug.
He needed it.
Hey, Mr. Dunn, look yonder.
What?
Somebody coming with a wagon.
Yeah. It's probably that Ben Walling they were talking about.
Wonder what he's got to say for himself.
Now, he'll think of something, Chester. His kind always does. Do you recognize him?
No, I don't. Do you?
No, I never saw him before.
Hey, what are you doing here?
You've been rolling.
How'd you know?
You've been away a long time, Ben. Where you been?
Who are you anyway, mister?
The U.S. Marshal.
Well, I went to fetch a doctor. Anything wrong in that?
No, not at all. Where is he?
Well, first night, them horses run away. I've been chasing them ever since. Didn't catch them till this morning.
I see.
How's old Hawtree? I'm kind of worried about that foot. Looked to me like it might have poison in it.
It did.
I mean, it did.
I took his leg off about noon today.
You who? How'd you know what to do? You might have killed him.
Somebody had to do it, Ben. It's a sure thing Tara couldn't.
You're blaming me, ain't you? I done everything I could. It ain't my fault them blasted horses run off.
Autry's pretty sick, man.
Well, Marshal, you can leave now. I'll handle everything.
We'll leave as soon as Autry's able to take care of himself again.
Stay as long as you like. I don't care.
John?
Yeah.
I think that cussy Ben's a real good liar.
You see that saddle over there, Chester?
Oh, well, that belongs to Mr. Hawthorne.
Yeah, I know. I looked at it this noon. Somebody cut the cinch strap on it.
Well, no wonder that belongs to Buck Jim and the saddle off both.
You think Tara did it?
It was Ben, wasn't it?
You think if the old man would get hurt, maybe killed?
Well, why?
So he'd have a free hand with Tara.
You should go and start me resting.
No, not yet, Chester. There's plenty of time.
All right. I'll wait. I could hurry in there and just break in her heart.
I'd give her a little time, Chester. She'll be all right.
Don't move a finger, either one of you.
Ah, you're mighty careless with that rifle.
Well, get smart with me, Marshal. I know what I'm doing.
And what would that be?
I heard you in there. Promised to take Tara away. I was right by the window. I heard it all.
You got a curious way of courting the girl, Ben, trying to kill her father.
Dan, I saw you yesterday looking at that sad. But I didn't kill him, Marshal. You did.
That's a lie. I've been wrong, and you know it. I won't shut up. We just got here sooner Mr. Dillon would have saved him, after
all. Well, too bad you got here at all, because you're going to die for it, both of you.
Put the gun down, Ben. You're under arrest for attempted murder.
See, right we are, Marshal.
You know, I got an idea you've smelled powder before, Ben, and that you're afraid of it. I got an idea that's Marshal. Why you tried to get Hawtree like you did instead of facing him.
Stop
huh?
right there.
And right now you wish you didn't have that rifle at all, don't you, Ben? Because
no.
I might have to shoot you for
no,
it.
No, don't, Marshal.
Give me
stop.
That.
Stop,
Dillon?
No, you didn't even try, Chester. The rifle went off when I knocked it aside, that's all. He was scared to death.
Well, I didn't feel exactly comfortable.
Tie him up and keep an eye on him, huh? I'll go see Tara. Late that evening, we buried Hawtree out on the prairie, out in back of the little homestead that would die now, too, and fall apart without him. The next morning, we loaded up everything we could get into the wagon, and with Tara beside me, we started out for Dodge. Ben Walling never said a word. Chester led his horse, and they rode along ahead of us. I had plenty of time to tell Tara all about Dodge, and how that there were some good people there, and how we'd find her a home and a family. We just sat there, tight-lipped. Didn't say much. She never once looked back.
Gunsmoke, produced and directed by Norman McDonald, stars William Conrad as Matt Dillon, U.S. Marshal. The story was specially written for Gunsmoke by John Meston. Featured in the cast were John Daner, Sammy Hill, and Lawrence Dobkin. Harley Bear is Chester.